We're going to determine the following limit numerically, which means they want us to complete a table of values to determine this limit. So we have the limit as x approaches negative 1 of 2 divided by the quantity x plus 1. So when we create our table, we're going to have x equals negative 1 in the middle. And then notice how we have 3 rows above and 3 rows below, where these 3 values approach negative 1 from the left, and these 3 values approach negative 1 from the right. Just to make sure that we agree on this, if we were to draw a number line, if this was negative 1, 0 would be to the right and negative 2 would be to the left. In between 0 and negative 1 would be negative 0.5, and over here we'd have negative 1.5. So somewhere in here we have negative 0.9, and somewhere here we have negative 1.1. So negative 0.9 is greater than negative 1. So these values are greater than negative 1, approaching from the right. And then negative 1.1 is less than negative 1. So these values are less than negative 1, approaching from the left. And now we'll substitute these x values into the function, and then analyze the table to determine what this limit would be. And we're going to go ahead and evaluate these on the graphing calculator. So the first thing we'll do is type in our function. So we press y equals, we have 2 divided by the quantity x plus 1. If we leave off the parentheses here, it would not be the same function. And now we're going to make sure that our table set is on ASCII mode. So if we press second window, make sure that your calculator is highlighted here on ASCII. If it isn't, we just go down, highlight ASCII, and then press enter. And now if we grow the table by pressing second graph, we can just type in these values from our table. We'll go ahead and just go straight down this first column, negative 1.1, negative 1.01, and negative 1.001. Let's go ahead and type in negative 1, even though we know this function is undefined at negative 1. The calculator will give us an error. We have negative 0.999. Negative 0.99, and then negative 0.9. So now we'll record these values in the table and then analyze the results. Notice as we approach negative 1 from the left side, these function values are increasing without bound, which means the limit as x approaches negative 1 to the left would be equal to negative infinity. And then if we look at the values approaching negative 1 from the right, notice how they're increasing without bound, so they're approaching positive infinity, which tells us the limit as x approaches negative 1 to the positive side or right side of 2 divided by the quantity x plus 1 is equal to positive infinity. Well, neither of these limits exist. So obviously the limit as x approaches negative 1 does not exist. So this is how we can determine a limit numerically by using a table of values. And just to emphasize this result, let's take a look at the graph. So as we approach negative 1 on the function, we're approaching this vertical line from the left and right. So as we approach negative 1 from the right side, you can see the function increases without bound, so it's approaching positive infinity. And as it approaches from the left, it's decreasing without bound, which means the function values are approaching negative infinity. So if you ever have difficulty determining a limit, the numerical approach is a little bit time consuming, but it is a nice way to verify a limit.